Hello and welcome to this new video. My name is Jan and I'm a Fortify Presales Consultant. And in this video, I want to give you a good overview about the Fortify Command Line Interface utility, or in short, FCLI. So that means we will cover, first of all, basic introduction. What is the FCLI? Then we will head into some use cases. And at the end, we will also cover how to download, install, and use it. But this is basically the first video out of a video series that we want to produce for you. So please make sure you have a look at the YouTube channel to don't miss any of these videos that are more specific to certain parts of FCLI or certain components. So with that, I would say we can directly start with the introduction of what is FCLI. So what's FCLI? In a few words, I would say that it is a single utility that unifies and simplifies most of the tooling that is responsible for any kind of interaction with Fortify products. So what do I mean with that? If you have a look at the right, you can see we have different solutions, different Fortify products. For example, we have the Fortify Software Security Center, Fortify On Demand, the Fortify Static Code Analyzer, and each of them has like any kind of integration. For example, we have the Fortify Software Security Center API. We have some command line tools that you can use on the Fortify Static Code Analyzer side, but there's like no unified way of communicating with each of these products or solutions. And the good thing here is FCLI is this solution. So it unifies and simplifies the way of communicating for any kind of interaction with Fortify. And the good thing here is it is also shipped into a single native binary. So you can use this on Windows, Linux, and Mac as well. We also ship a jar file that you can use. So it is very powerful and you can use this across different operating systems. And to showcase you a little bit more, I prepared some use cases where you can really benefit from FCLI. And the first thing that came in my mind here was the CI/CD integration. Of course, we have a lot of out-of-the-box plugins that you can use for different CI/CD systems, but with FCLI, we can create a consistent and a repeatable way of doing any kind of CI and CD integration. So that means regardless of which CI and CD tool you're using, FCLI will provide the same functionality in all of them, because it doesn't matter if we have a plugin for this CI/CD system. We only need to have access to the command line or to make sure it is some kind of command line job in there. And this is really, really powerful because you can copy paste commands or functions that you want to use in any kind of CI/CD pipeline very, very easily. And this is the first case use case where you can use FCLI or where you get a lot of benefits out of this. The next use case, if you want to use it for a cross Fortify product integration. What do I mean with that? For example, you have a software security center that is installed on premise, and you also have Fortify On Demand available. And you want sometimes to do some single downloads and uploads, so ad hoc uploads and downloads of some results. Of course, you can use the API of the software security center or the Fortify On Demand uploader to upload it on the command line, but there's like no simple way of doing this for ad hoc downloads and uploads, for example. And you can use the Fortify command line for that. Another use case here, if you have the Software Security Center and Scan Central SAST, one use case could be that whenever you want to run a Scan Central SAST scan, you first check if the version is already on the Software Security Center side. And that's, yeah, it's possible to do it manually, of course, but there's like no simple and unified way to doing it. And with the Fortify command line, it is very simple to do that. And that's, yeah, the second use case that I want to mention. The first use case, you can start creating more complex workflows. For example, if you have something like ServiceNow, you can use the Fortify Command Lines or FCLI to pull, for example, the Software Security Center for a specific event. And from this event, you can react or you can trigger something. You can create alerts. You can create email notifications, something like this. So it's really, really powerful. So there are a ton of different use cases or a ton of different possible workflows, but you can start creating these because it is simple to use. It is very powerful, and it is possible to create more complex workflows with the FCLI. And the last use case that I have in mind here is the topic of data export and data mining or filtering. So with FCLI, we have a ton of options when it comes to output formats. You can do things like JSON, YAML, CSV, table, tree. So there are really a ton of options that you can use. But it is also very interesting that you can do a lot of filtering or curing with it. So, of course, for example, if we have a software security center, there are already some ways of filtering that you can do on the API, for example. But with the Fortify command line, with FCLI, we do, first of all, the server-side filtering, but we can also do the client-side filtering. So some functionalities are depending on this client-side filtering. So you can do a lot more that you could use usually do on just the server side. So you can start exporting the different data into your system in different formats. And from them, you can start add some additional filters as well. So for these use case, it is very, very powerful. And as I said, these are just four example use cases. There are more, and we will also going through that in the next couple of videos. But just to give you understanding for what kind of use cases you can use the FCLI. But now, of course, the question is, how can you use it or how can you download it? And the first thing, it is very easy to download and install. You only need to go to the GitHub project that is linked in the video description, and where you need to have a look at the releases that are available and just download the binary that you need for Windows, for Linux, for Mac, or just the jar file. That's the first step. And then you can start using it. And just to give you an overview, here is the way of how you can use FCLI. So all commands within FCLI are organized using the following structure, so the following conventions. First of all, we have, of course, FCLI. Then we have the product. So for example, here in this case, SSC, we also have Scan Central SAST, Scan Central DAST, Fortify on Demand. So you need to select or you need to say, okay, what kind of product you want to use. Then there is the entity. So in the case of the Software Security Center, we have, for example, app versions. This can also be users, for example. So we have different options here. Then we have the verb. Do we want to list it? Do we want to create a new app version? And then we have the options like the output in a JSON format. So it is very simple to use. And by the way, we also have a feature for the auto completion. That's very powerful, very make things a lot easier that you can already use to test everything out. But this is the way how you use the FCLI. But if you want to learn more of how to use it, how to configure it, we will cover this in the upcoming videos. But you can also use the documentation that is also linked down in the video description. So I highly recommend to have a look at that. And of course, the GitHub project itself and also the releases, because you can download it from there. And with that, I would say this is already the end of this overview video. As I said, we will going to upload a lot more on this soon. So please make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments. But with that, I would say thank you very much for your time, and I wish you a nice day.